could say that I had some of the symptoms that Jennifer faced, and I, you might have no idea that this is true, but I'm a little bit hyper. I tend to be. I mean, how do I know if this is something that I may suffer from or someone at home may be suffering
from? Well, again, so self-report's important. As adults, usually it's saying, you know, I'm not focusing at work. A history of ADHD or ADD as a child, and then the fact you have an impairment in at least a work or school, a relationship, you might have poor attention. And also, for adults, instead of the hyperactivity, you might find that you maybe have issues of temper. You have stress intolerance, you still are inattentive. So it's a combination of symptoms that means that you probably should talk to a healthcare provider, focus on your relationships and what's happening, and self-report. And also, there are screening tools that you can use.
And Jennifer, we should add that you've done a lot of coaching and all your personal experience, you've noticed these are not chronic symptoms. It's not like if I forget my keys one day, all of a sudden I have ADD, right?
Well, right. You know, everyone forgets their keys sometimes. Everyone gets distracted. Everyone gets disorganized. But when you have adult ADD, this actually, you know, these challenges impact the quality of your life, and that's where the difference comes in.
So how do you manage this effectively on a day-to-day basis?
Well, you know, I think that the most important thing is stress management. So for me, I try to keep my stress levels down, and, you know, I always tell my clients, stress management equals ADD management. So that means, for me at least, you know, taking at least half an hour a day to unplug, recharge, and make sure that I'm, you know, stepping away from the stress of everyday life. And I also think it's really important to be in control of your time and your schedule. So I'll take 15 minutes each and every day to review my to-do list and to make sure that I plan my day in advance.
And Janet, is medicine an option?
Well, it's definitely an option. I mean, it's part of the therapy. I think the stress management or self-management is one component, but medication with stimulants or non-stimulants is important. And also psychoeducation, where you really educate yourself about the symptoms and then you can learn what to do. But medication definitely, in most people diagnosis, indicated and helpful.
Dr. Genitalia Taylor, Jennifer Kratzky, thank you so much.
Thank you.
We'll be right back. But first, this is Today on NBC.